We've been sailing. A few months ago, we headed out to the Channel Islands, but in a different direction than our normal heading. We were heading to the southernmost of the Channel Islands in hopes of setting foot on Santa Barbara, San Clemente, and San Nicolas Island. On the Channel Island crossing around midnight, it got to be pretty rough. The next day, though, once we reached Santa Barbara Island, it had really calmed down. The national park was closed due to the fact that the pier was mangled by weather, so we decided to accidentally beach the kayaks and had some fun exploring this island that none of us had seen before. After a night at Santa Barbara Island, we headed for San Clemente for our first ever rendezvous, and it happened to be with Harrison Ealy, the man that sold Capaz to Julius and Stephanie a couple years ago. There was a huge south swell pulsing through, and none of the surf spots were working, so we decided to paddle around the boats a bit and swim around while dinner was being made. I will fight for you. On this island every day I see you crying, baby, please know that I'm trying to be brave. I'll build a raft for you, I'd sail into the afternoon, I'd do anything to get you free. No, it's gonna be a long, long night. Oh, it's gonna be a long. Harrison's new catamaran, Good Vibrations, is much more modern than Capaz, and it was fun to look at the similarities and the differences between the cats. After dinner, we sat around on Good Vibrations, catching up and telling stories. Harrison has some crazy stories. He's been around the San Diego shoreline his entire life, from being the second member of the San Diego Yacht Club ever, to being the first person to surf Cortez Bank. He's had more experience on the ocean than anyone that I've ever met. The next day, we did some diving on the other side of the island with everybody. While diving around, we quickly set foot on this island as well. So two down, one to go. I will fight for you. As we said goodbye to Harrison and Good Vibrations, we pointed our bow directly into the wind and started chugging along towards the final island.
Hi, how's it going?
We're doing things a little like
on our way to San Nicolas Island. We've been motoring for how long? I'd say around 7+ hours.
It is now 7 o'clock and we started at 11 a.m.
A little rough. Really windy, but we can't sail because we're going directly into it. That's San Nicolas Island. Least visited of all the Channel Islands. We're not sailing, but we're getting there. You want to do what?
I can't wait to freaking turn this engine off.
Yeah.
When we finally got to San Nicolas Island, the wind was blowing upwards of 40 knots. The
The next morning was exceptionally calm, which made it perfect for a very fast mission to the beach, to do a little dance and rush back to Capaz. Normally when we do a beach landing on any other island, we take our time and really enjoy the experience, but for San Nicolas and San Clemente, that isn't the case. These islands are military bases with extremely high security, protecting our government secrets from bad guys like us. But we made it back just fine and checked the third island off of our list. As we headed home, we decided to stop by Anacapa Island as a rest stop. It gave us a chance to do some kayaking and made the fifth island in 5 days that we had stopped at. Stopping at San Nicolas in the morning was the eighth island out of all eight Channel Islands that everybody had set foot on, making everybody members of the eight island club. Everybody, that is, except me. I still have to get myself onto Catalina. One of these days.